everyone. My name is Sagon Warintharaporn. All you can call me Teacher Boy, a chemistry teacher at Gamnut Wit Science Academy. First of all, we know already that the smallest unit in all substances is the atom. Most atoms do not stay isolated as a single unit. They usually form linkages together, giving bigger molecules or substances with various properties. For example, the hard but brittle rock salt, the unbreakable diamond, or metals that can be shaped into thin foil. These different properties are caused by different types of linkages between atoms. In substances, this is what we call chemical bonding. And this is what we will focus on today. There are three types of chemical bonds: ionic bonds, covalent bonds, and metallic bonds. What are the differences among them? The type of chemical bonding in substances relates to electronic interactions among atoms. To understand electronic interactions, we have to understand the concept of the properties of the elements. One concept of the properties of the elements we have to focus on is electronegativity. The electronegativity, or EN, is the value which reflects the tendency of an atom to attract electrons towards itself. The magnitude of this value is presented in the Pauling scale. The electronegativity of atoms is affected by the radius of atom. Bigger atoms will have lower EN compared to smaller atoms due to the greater distance between the nucleus and valence electrons. The trend of EN in the periodic table is shown by EN values increasing from the bottom to the top of each group and from left to right across a period. Therefore, fluorine, being at the top right corner of the periodic table, has the highest EN value. On the other hand, francium, the element at the extreme bottom left, has the lowest EN value. This trend of EN values correlates with the metallic and non-metallic properties of the elements. You can see there are three types of elements highlighted by different colors, and these have different metallic and non-metallic properties. Firstly, metals are found in the blue area of the periodic table. These elements usually have low EN values. This means that metals do not attract electrons much, but prefer to give them away. The next type of elements are the nonmetals, found in the yellow upper right section of the periodic table. They typically have high EN values. This means that these elements prefer to draw electrons to themselves. The last group is highlighted in green at the borderline between metals and nonmetals. The elements in this area are called metalloids, and they have EN values between those of metals and nonmetals. We will now go into details of the first type of bonding, which is ionic bonding. Let's imagine if we place a metal and a nonmetal together. One loves to give away electrons, and the other loves to draw electrons towards it. They are a perfect couple, and this will cause electron transfer from the metal to the nonmetal, which is the main mechanism behind bond formation. This mechanism occurs because of the big difference in EN values, which causes the metal atom to lose its electron and turn into a positive ion called a cation. The nonmetal atom gains this electron to form a negative ion called an anion. When the cation and the anion stay close together, they will be attracted to each other. This attraction force is ionic bond. The ionic bond is based on electrostatic attraction. Let's imagine we have many cations and anions together. For example, in the sample of sodium chloride or table salt. If we consider the structure of table salt at the atomic level, we will see positively charged sodium ions and negatively charged chloride ions alternating in the structure. Ionic salts are hard solids due to the strong ionic bonds. Rock salt is brittle due to the ability of ion layers to slide when an external force is applied, which can lead to the repulsion of the similar charges. This concept of ion arrangements will occur in other ionic salts as well, but these will look different depending on the type of salt. The next type of chemical bond is the covalent bond. We will consider the word covalent first. Co means together, and valent comes from valence electron. So, a covalent bond is a bond where two atoms share valence electrons together. For example, if there are two nonmetal atoms together, since their EN values are not that different, valence electrons between them will not transfer from one to the other completely, like in an ionic bond. However, they will use or share these electrons together, which is the main mechanism for covalent bond formation. For example, there is one valence electron in a hydrogen atom. If we place two hydrogen atoms together, they will share electrons and turn to be a diatomic hydrogen molecule, which is more stable than being as two free atoms. A bond is formed between two atoms by sharing two electrons, which is presented as a solid line. Covalent bonds are not present only in hydrogen gas, but also present in many substances with different properties such as diamond, which has a network of covalent bonds among carbon atoms, causing this substance to be extremely hard from the strong bonding. Another example is the water molecule, which has two covalent bonds between one oxygen and two hydrogen atoms and has a bent shape. This example is an interesting case. The bond between oxygen and hydrogen is a relatively polar covalent bond, caused by different electronegativity values between them. The character of this bond is between that of a nonpolar covalent and an ionic bond, with each atom having a partial charge. In this case, the oxygen atom having higher EN will be able to attract the shared bonded electrons more and become partially negative. On the other hand, the hydrogen atom with lower EN will be partially positive. From the polarity and arrangement of its bonds, water is a polar molecule, which you can see from this experiment. When we bring the plastic comb, which is run through the hair for a while, near the water stream, the water stream will be attracted by the charged comb. The last type of chemical bond is the metallic bond. If we have metal atoms staying close together, the main mechanism for this kind of bond formation is electron pooling. Let's imagine again. Previously, we have shown already that metals love to give away electrons and turn to be cations. Consider a metal chunk with many metal atoms staying close together. At the atomic level, there are many metallic cores throwing electrons out already. Each atom presented in a metallic crystal loses all of its valence electrons. As a result, a pool of electrons is formed. Positively charged metal ions are held together by this pool of electrons. The electrons going out from the metallic cores can swim around the structure like water and hold everything together. The electron sea or electron pool is the pool of electrons which holds all metal cores together. This mechanism of bond formation causes metals to be able to be deformed as thin as metal foil without cracking as in ionic salts. These are the different mechanisms of chemical bond formation that come from the different characters of electron interactions. Thank you for your attention. That's all for today.